So we're going to do the Daniel fast. I just really want to encourage you all to take part in some way, shape, or form. Really encouraging you to set your course, decide what you're believing for, and really determining what you're going to be laying aside. The Daniel fast encompasses not only the body, but also the mind and the spirit. And with this video, I want to talk to you a little bit about how it involves your mind. How does a fast involve our mind? So a fast is detoxing and cleansing, and then refocusing and refilling. So as we approach the Daniel fast and as we come into this, we really have to decide, as far as our mind is concerned, what this is gonna entail, okay? So to get started with this, I am gonna read to you a passage. This is out of the Passion Translation. This is Colossians 3, verses 2 through 10. I do a little skipping over a few little spots, but I want you to just listen. Sit back and listen to these words. They are amazing. So here we go. Feast on all of the treasures of the heavenly realm and fill your thoughts with heavenly realities and not the distractions of the natural realm. Your crucifixion with Christ has severed your ties to this life, and now your life is hidden away in God in Christ. And as Christ is seen for who he really is, who you really are will also be revealed. For you are now one with him in his glory. Live as one who has died to every form of sexual sin and impurity. Live as one who died to desires for forbidden things. It's time to eliminate them from your lives once and for all. Anger, fits of rage, hatred, cursing, filthy speech, lying, laying aside your old Adam self with its masquerade in disguise, for you have acquired new creation life, which is continually being renewed into the likeness of the one who created you. That portion of scripture is amazing. And that portion of scripture really defines what a Daniel fast is for our mind. So if we go through all of the trouble and work to go on a Daniel fast for our body, take on the diet, take on eating more plant-based foods and giving up meat and sweets and alcohol and really simplifying drinking down to just water and really rehydrating, if we do all that and our minds have not been reined in or cleansed as well or detoxed of what it usually does on a normal day, we have just done a nice diet. And I don't want that to be. I want the Daniel fast to be effective physically. Yes, we're going to do things in a much more healthy, much more light way, freeing our body really from a lot of toxic dietary habits. But secondly, I want our minds to be freed. And so here's what it looks like. 21 days of different for your mind. So first of all, we have to decide, what are we going to detox? What are we going to cleanse? What are we going to step away from? And as far as our minds are concerned, we want to step away from distractions. All of these brain binkies that I've talked about that before, those things that we just naturally kind of come home after a hard day and we want to just zone out. And so we plug in a video, we plug in a movie, we turn on the TV, we sit down. And I am so on this, because I am one of these where I come home now and I have found myself just sitting down and just going like this and spending so much time just trying to detox my brain from a busy day. And it didn't used to be that way. We used to do it in other ways that were so much more healthy. So I want to encourage you to begin to identify what are some of the things that are distractions in your mind. The things that you go to that satiate you, that calm you, that distract you. Because what they're doing is they're stopping you from thinking. And that's just kind of the end of it. If you want to be someone that God can birth a dream in, you got to have brain space. We have to have mind space. We have to have margin inside of our minds to allow the Lord to think and to dream and to expand and imagine. We're not imagining anymore. We're just passively watching others. And so part of these 21 days of different you are going to survive 21 days without all that crazy input and overstimulation. You really will. And I think you're going to find a place of peace. You know, so many Christians are crying out, people are crying out for peace. There's just no peace in my world. Well, part of the problem is that we don't ever get quiet. We don't ever have quiet space for our brains to breathe. So, detoxing and cleansing from distractions. I'm going to ask that you fast or decide what would work for you, but you would fast those things that bring distraction. Social media, TV, movies, secular music, anything that takes your brain space all up, just stop it for 21 days. No more. And you might say, what am I going to do then? I'm going to be so bored. Well, we're going to do other things. This is going to be 21 days of different ways of spending our brain space, our brain energy. Okay. And so we're going to separate from distractions, but we're also going to separate from mental sins. Mental things that miss the mark of who Christ is, because those mental things have the potential of just taking us away from the things of God. So if you really feel like the Holy Spirit has been marking you and drawing you out and calling you out on things, anything, I mean, I listed a bunch of this stuff here, fits of rage, hatred, cursing, filthy speech, lying. But I'd like to add to that jealousy or, you know, any of those kinds of things that the Holy Spirit's been just really tugging on you. Let's make a concerted effort that that's some more that you're going to fast. Whenever those things come up, you say to yourself, no, I'm going to replace you with something better. So what are we going to focus and fill our lives with? Because I don't want you bored. I certainly don't want you bored. I don't want you sitting around just doing nothing, because that's not what we're made to do. We are made to do things. We're made to produce. We're made to be. And so I'm going to ask you to consider your Bible reading. First of all, if you're going to sit down and you want that phone and that feels really good to have this phone and have something electronic and have a screen, then you know what? Download a Bible app. And then determine that over 21 days, you're not going to spend 2 to 3 hours a day on social media, but instead you're going to read through the New Testament. When was the last time you read the New Testament? It's amazing. And it's not that long. You could easily read the New Testament. So I would love for your spouse or someone in your family to catch you sitting on the couch with your phone reading the Word. I really want to challenge you to do this. Replace your screen time with reading the Word. Also, we have some books that we want to encourage you to do as a body. We're going to be reading some books just, you know, body-wide, but I'm sure you have some books that you know that were really good that you would love to pick up, and we're going to have a list of the books that we're going to recommend that's embedded into this video here. So books, I want to encourage you to replace and refill your time and your space with worship music. Turn off all secular music for just a small 21 days. You will survive. And put it in, plug in worship music. Potentially, you could just have some conversation. If you were to unplug your brain from everything else, I think you might discover that there's some interesting conversation to be had by those around you. So conversation. I want to encourage you that if you have children or people that you live with, and it comes to be dinner time, have a book, have a devotional, read it during dinner. Don't just jump up and run. Have some time where you're going to sit and pray together as a family. Take some time to unplug and detune as a family as well. Practice Philippians 4, verses 4 through 9. Whatsoever is pure, think on these things. Whatsoever is right and good and of a good report, practice all those things. Because I want to remind you, like that scripture said, you are not your old Adam self with its masquerade and disguises. Some of those things are very, very handy to hide behind and to disguise yourself with. But let's take that all away and let's really build up the real you, the one that's being revealed in Christ. It's going to be amazing. 21 days of different in your mind. 21 days of think thinking different thoughts of going about things. So I want to encourage you that for these 21 days, you're going to set your table with healthy, and with clean food, you're going to set your mind on things above. And in our next video, I'm going to encourage you how to set your spirit on the things of the spirit. So let's do this thing. 21 days of difference. I am challenging you. Do this with us and see what happens.